Hi everyone, welcome back. This is Mike from Liquid Audio in Perth, Western Australia. Liquid Audio, cherishing classic audio. And speaking of audio, we've got an Audiolab 8000A integrated amplifier. This is a gorgeous little integrated amp from Audiolab, a famous British hi-fi manufacturer who were big back in the 80s. Unfortunately, the Audiolab now is no longer the actual Audiolab. It's like Chinese Audiolab, which is very, very different. But anyway, this is a lovely amp. Let's have a look. We've got an input selector here, rotary control, probably one of the last few record out selectors that you'll see there, which was obviously made for, you know, cassette, which was big back in the day. Defeatable tone controls, which is always nice. Balance, volume, headphone socket. So it's a fully featured integrated. But what I wanted to show you was just why this integrated is such a lovely piece of gear to work on and why it's so beautifully designed. I wanted to show you some of the key design features. So if we have a look here, we've got a nice big toroidal transformer, and that really is big for what is a very modestly powered 60 watt per channel amp. We've got a couple of Elner filter capacitors here. These are quite large actually. They're 10,000 microfarad each, which is pretty generous, again, for the spec of the amp. Really, that's you know, they've obviously sort of thought, let's make this properly. You'll notice that they're mounted horizontally, and that's because of the form factor of this amp. It's a little more than one rack unit tall. You know, you can see here from my hand, it's fairly slim, if you like, slimline design. So these would not fit standing up vertically, so they've had to mount them horizontally. But that's fine, they're pretty secure. And if we have a look here, the board is, you know, secure underneath. They've got some sort of a mounting post there. But there are some other absolutely beautiful features that I wanted to point out. Look at the board. It's a one-piece design. So all of the input connectors are mounted to the board. All of the switches and controls are also mounted directly to the board. And of course, whenever you can do this, you minimize or reduce wiring, or eliminate, in this case, all of the wiring from the controls. There's no wiring there. There's no wiring from inputs. The only wiring really is to the speaker terminals and some of this filter and power supply wiring. So, you know, this is very good for improving reliability often. You know, there's nothing wrong with wires as long as they're, you know, done properly with good quality wiring. But, you know, wiring something can induce noise if it's not wired correctly, if it's not routed correctly. And, you know, this certainly simplifies a lot of design elements, like mounting things directly to the board reduces production costs, eliminates the need for wiring, and shortens all the signal paths. So from that point of view, it's very, very lovable. But there's a lot of other lovable design elements in this amp. Let's start at the phono pre. We've got some very, very nice Elner, high quality Elner filter caps here in the phono pre. We've got, you might notice that there are four sockets here. Two of those are for moving magnet, two are for moving coil, and the input is selectable here on the back. You'll notice that it's an all discrete design, and it features very nicely mounted, good quality discrete transistors with also some nice film capacitors. These film caps and these 1% metal resistors will all be in the RIAA equalization network. That's all to provide the correct equalization for this phono preamp so that when you play a record, it sounds like it should sound. And then you've got lots and lots of discrete transistors here. Everything's beautifully marked. You've got a nice, some high current devices here. This is a regulator that's heat sinked directly to the chassis. You can see how that's been done. But you know, it's all beautifully done. Again, with phono stages, it's important not to have too much wiring and to have a really short signal path and good quality discrete components where you can. And that's what they've done here. They've even used some polystyrene capacitors, which are, you know, known basically to be the best sorts of caps that you can use in the signal path, MKS or polystyrene, styrene film, styroseal. They are really, really, really good caps. Let's have a look under here. Under here we've got all the tone control stuff and what looks to be like the line buffer. I would suggest the line input buffer. So this just makes sure that you know, all the circuit blocks are matched in terms of impedance and provides the tone control facilities. And then here we've got, you know, what essentially here is the amplifier block. And that consists of, down here, we've got the pre-driver stage. Here we've got the driver stage with these little heatsink TO220s. And then here with the big Sanken output devices bolted directly to this gorgeous machined aluminium heatsink. That's the actual output stage, if you like, or those are the output devices that drive the speakers. So at each stage, we have more current available to drive speakers. So let's have a bit more of a look down here at some of this. Again, beautiful layout. Notice all the board designators. Everything is clearly labeled. You can see exactly what's meant to go where, down to the type of transistor that's meant to be in each position. You'll also note down here, got some gorgeous little, these are not integrated circuits, they're actually dual FET packages. So there's two FETs in one package here, probably JFETs, 2SK389, I don't know what that is, but it's a FET because of the 2SK designator. So that's two matched FETs in one package, and the same here. Now, these things are not cheap. Audiolab has done this because it's a great way to go from an electrical standpoint. They have a super high input impedance, meaning they essentially draw no current from any source. They don't present a load to a source, which is, you know, the way an ideal circuit element here would work. And MOSFETs are just beautiful. FETs are just fantastic things. So all the way through here, we've got conventional bipolar devices, but you'll note again that it's all discrete. We've got some higher current devices mounted here to these little aluminium blocks, which heat sink them nicely. And then finally, we have these Sanken complementary pairs mounted to this beautiful, as I said, machined aluminium heat sink. They didn't spare any expense with this part of it. They really wanted to make it reliable and build it properly. And do it in such a way that it would be repairable in the future, as you can see. Everything here is very repairable. Now, this amplifier came to me with a fault, and I have since fixed that fault. There was a fault with the input selector. There was a fault with some noisy controls, and in fact, there were some dry joints, just only a few dry joints underneath this area of board where all the high current stuff is happening and where things are getting hot. So I touched those up. I've just finished trimming out the bias. So the bias current is now set for both channels, and the amp is actually working really, really well. No more noise, everything's absolutely quiet, works beautifully. So this is just a very nice example of an amp that's built properly. This is nothing like what you can buy now, guys. The stuff that's made in China now is absolutely a world apart from this stuff that you can see here. This is really, really nicely designed and laid out. It was expensive at the time, but that's for good reason. You can see that the engineering that's gone into this. And what that means is that 20 years later, 30 years later, it still works perfectly. So that's something very lovable to say about older gear like this. So anyway, that's a quick overview of the Audiolab 8000A. If there's anything that I can help with in terms of your hi-fi equipment, please hit me up here at Liquid Audio in Perth, Western Australia. Visit my website, liquidaudio.com.au. Thanks for watching. Hi, this is just a follow-up to the Audiolab 8000A video that I started with before. I was talking about the great build quality of this amp, and you know, it is very nicely put together. It's a 60 watt per channel amp, not 100 as I might have said before. But I wanted to just sort of point out a couple of things here that make servicing so good on an amp like this. This is the main board. One big board with all components mounted to it. Now, if you look more closely, I'm working here on the sort of driver section and outputs. Every single component designator is clearly marked. All the parts, you know, names are there, not the values, but the names. So you can look those parts up on the schematic. But you know, everything is there. It's clear to see. You can see what everything is. You can see the orientation and location of all the electrolytics. These are all the ones that I want to test. The ones that you can see in the pic now. See if you can spot them near the high current devices. And if I quickly flip this over, once again, you know, you can see again why I like this thing so much, why I like the layout so much. Really good quality fiberglass board. All the parts designators here, and this time they do say what the parts are, so right down to the individual transistors. Look, BC560s, ZTEX 753. You know, they're all here. Everything is marked. Every capacitor is marked. Little Zener diode, 12 volt Zener diode there, and next to a 1N4148. All the resistors. This is what you call really, really helpful. I mean, this is helpful if you don't have a schematic, but of course we've got the schematic and it's just even more helpful to have all of this. So, you know, just thought I'd sort of mention that not all circuit boards are the same and not all builds are the same. The build quality and the production values, they vary enormously. This is something where they cared about serviceability and they cared about making it easy to work on at some point later. So anyway, Audiolab 8000A, really nice, very lovable amplifier. Well done, Audiolab.